Well, we want to take a look at some of the key aspects around the telecommunications industry, and I'm now joined by Livingstone Migwi, the general manager for Tecno. Let's just begin by looking at the smartphone business that you are in. You've recently launched the Phantom 5.
Yep.
Tell us what's really driving the release of such products in the Kenyan market, really.
Okay, thank you for having us, for having me in the interview. We launched the Phantom 5 yesterday. It's our flagship product for 2015. And the reason why we are launching it right now is because the Kenyan consumer has become quite discerning, has become very discerning. They're looking for a device that is an extension of their lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
That can be able to marry both their professional life and the social life.
Mm-hmm.
The reason for this particular product is because, as Tecno, we believe that technology should not be expensive.
Mm-hmm.
All the aspects that you get on a device should not cost you an arm and a leg.
Mm-hmm.
So we pack as much technology in a device that will give you all the high-end features,
mm-hmm.
that is still very affordable to,
mm-hmm.
to the consumer. The market in Kenya has, the smartphone market in Kenya has grown significantly within
mm-hmm.
the last few years. This has been driven primarily by the internet penetration and the introduction of course, fiber optic and
correct.
Speaking
about internet penetration, what are really customers looking out for?
Mm-hmm.
Is it the enhanced features?
Mm-hmm.
Is it the pricing? What
yeah.
are they looking out for when it comes to buying a phone, really?
Okay, the consumer is looking for a phone that can be able to both give you style in terms of design as well as enhanced features. Camera is key for anyone who is looking at a personal device,
mm-hmm.
and also other aspects of the device that can also be able to marry your professional life and your social life. So if you're looking at a device like the Phantom 5,
mm-hmm.
that has fantastic camera features, has very good memory for your storage for the same photos that you're going to take, has very good random access memory that will make the device run smoothly,
mm-hmm.
when you're doing all this multitasking, you're either on social media or you're
mm-hmm.
accessing your emails, you're doing all these things on your device. So the consumer is looking for features that can be able to bridge the gap between your work and as well as your social life.
What would you say about the trends we've seen in the
mm-hmm.
Kenyan market, where new entrants coming on board, the likes of Huawei,
yep.
As well as Microsoft,
mm-hmm.
And also the
mm-hmm.
iPhone.
Yeah.
As Tecno, how do you plan to tackle the stiffening competition in the market, really?
I think if you look at the statistics, only 60%, around 60% of the devices sold in Kenya are smartphones. If you look at the attachment rate on mobile, on the operators, it's around 4 to 5 million smartphones are attached on the network.
Mm-hmm.
Out of that, we have close to 32 million consumers already in the market. So there is space for growth. That's why people are seeing the opportunity and coming into this market.
Mm-hmm.
The differentiating factor between us and the other operators, the other vendors, is that
mm-hmm.
we have been in this market for the last 5 years. We have developed this market from the ground up,
mm-hmm.
and we know the consumer. We believe we are a customer-centric organization. We understand what the consumer wants. They want good features, but they don't want to pay a lot of money for it. So
mm-hmm.
what we have done is packaged a device that can give you fantastic features, but we will be at an affordable price.
Mm-hmm.
So we expect more entrants into the market because there's opportunity.
Yeah.
There's significant opportunity in this market.
Correct.
But we are ready to take on the competition,
mm-hmm.
because we understand the consumer in the Kenyan market.
Speaking about Tecno being customer centric,
yeah.
we've also seen your brand
yeah.
being associated with there are issues around reputation
yep.
when it comes to the pricing of the
uh-huh.
product
uh-huh.
and also imitation of other brands in
uh-huh.
the market.
Okay.
What would be your reaction to this?
Okay, I think to be told, there is that perception in the market that we do try to price our devices very low and also pick some items
mm-hmm.
from the other vendors. But what I would like to tell you is that what we do how we produce, how we design our products is directly reflective of what the customers want. Mm-hmm. It's not copying a device from, say, for example, Samsung or Nokia or whatever. It's what we go to the consumer on the ground and ask them, what do you want in a device? Mm-hmm. So the consumer will tell us they want a good camera, mm-hmm. they want a good music phone, they want a good phone in terms of storage, and we go back to our R&D department in Shanghai and develop a product around that. Mm-hmm. Now, if you look at our designs within the last 1 or so years, you see a shift in the philosophy of the design. We are becoming more innovative in the design of the product. Mm-hmm. We are putting more features on the product that are different from the other manufacturers. Like if you look, for example, at the Phantom 5 that we just launched yesterday,
yes,
the fingerprint scanner at the back only takes 0.7 seconds to enable you access your device. Mm-hmm. That is not available with anyone else. Mm-hmm. If you look at the camera that we have on the Phantom 5, it has a dual flash at the back and it also has a flash at the front. Mm-hmm. No one else has that in the market. Mm-hmm. So we are trying to differentiate ourselves in a very competitive and very grayed out, in terms of grid lined environment where vendors have almost similar features. Mm-hmm. So you need to differentiate yourself with every device that you bring into the market.
Interesting that you pointed out that.
Yeah.
Still looking at the phone industry in Kenya, there's also that challenge when it comes to counterfeit goods coming into the country.
Yeah.
I don't know, how hard have you been hit as Tecno?
To tell you the truth, it's a challenge that not just Tecno is suffering. It's across board. All the other manufacturers also tell you the truth, mm-hmm. the same. Grey import is a big issue for us.
Mm-hmm.
And the challenge is we have very porous borders that allow some of these goods to come in.
Could you give us some numbers really in terms of from a sales perspective, mm-hmm. how much has this dented your revenues really?
In terms of denting of revenue, it may not really be that significant. The challenge has been reputation,
mm-hmm.
because someone will put a name on a product,
mm-hmm.
and then when the consumer buys and they find out that it's defective,
mm-hmm.
they only know Tecno. They don't know anyone else. So it's more of a reputational damage than a revenue leak. Because as much as we try to fight them using the government and using random checks,
mm-hmm.
they still come through. The main challenge we have is reputational damage, which we are trying to shift around by educating customers on what to expect on a Tecno device.
Uh-huh.
We are doing a lot of market storms and education on the ground, mm-hmm. At the point of sale to tell the customer what they need to look out for, mm-hmm. on a genuine Tecno device.
And maybe Migwi, as we wind up, looking at the trends we've seen, the uptake of the smartphone, as a company, what's your outlook like when it comes to which sectors are you expecting the biggest growth to come from, really, in terms of your product?
I think the youth market is significant. It's a growing market.
Mm-hmm.
We are designing products that are targeted on specific segments. And one segment that we are really focusing on is the youth segment. That's where you'll see us bringing a lot of entertainment on the go or on our devices, from the entry-level device all the way to the Phantom 5, which is the most expensive Tecno device. So there will be elements of music, elements of apps that can be able to allow you to access music, stream mm-hmm. music, and all that,
mm-hmm.
as in an entertainment device that you can be able to enjoy on the go. So the youth market, the youth segment is significant for us.
Mm-hmm.
We also seen a lot of growth in the mid tier between $200 and $300 device, because as you acquire your first smartphone, which might be the entry level smartphone, you start learning about new features.
Mm-hmm.
So the consumer grows through the path of the specifications.
Mm-hmm.
So when the smartphone was introduced in Kenya, people started off with the entry level device. Now people have started looking for more on the device.
Uh-huh.
So we are designing products that have superior camera, mm-hmm. you can be able to take photos at night, and this is unique to Tecno. Our camera is, you can be able to take very clear photos on low light. So there's a series that we have launched called the C-Series mm-hmm. that is focused on the camera. Mm-hmm. It also packs all the other elements of music and good battery life and all that, but it's a central camera focused device. Mm-hmm. Then the high-end device, which is the Phantom 5, now combines all these elements together. Uh-huh. There will be the music and the camera, good battery life, and good internet experience on 4G.
Of course, as you're saying, to catch the youth market, there needs to be a lot of marketing, really. True. How big is your advertising budget, really?
I might not be able to give you the budget, but what we do is that we do a lot of storms in campuses. We do a lot of storms in areas that youth come together. Mm-hmm. We have a very vibrant social media team that is always talking to the youth. Mm-hmm. We always get in a lot of feedback from the consumer, from the Kenya consumer, on what they want us to bring into the market. Mm-hmm. And we try as much as possible to be at the point where the customer is buying the device, or where the decision point at which the customer is making the purchase mm-hmm. Decision. We try as much as possible to be present there. So mm-hmm. in terms of ensuring that the youth market is tapped, we are planning and we continue doing various university storms, college storms, even now we are trying to get it into the secondary area where we catch them before they start getting the first device mm-hmm. and educating them on what you can be able to do on your smartphone.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Lastly, of course, Migwi, looking at the telecommunications industry, are there some interventions you would like to see the regulator bringing on board just to make sure that the environment is conducive for players like you and others? What would be some of the key aspects you'd want addressed in the sector?
I think all the manufacturers will tell you this. The VAT bill on devices has been a big pain for us, and not just for us, but also for the consumer.
How big?
Because the consumer now has to pay an extra premium to access the device.
Mm-hmm. If you Does this really affect the sales volumes?
It initially did, and right now it's stabilizing. If you look at, by the time the VAT, the 16% VAT on devices was introduced, sales were two or three times what we have now. Mm-hmm. Also, this has also opened up now the floodgates to bring in counterfeit products, and also to bring in devices that, there are some people who are bringing devices that are not paying tax. So you end up having a very unbalanced market. So we would like the regulator and the government to look at VAT. I think it's a key pain point, not just for the manufacturer, but also for the consumer. Mm-hmm. If you want to accelerate the growth of the internet and the growth of access to the internet, mm-hmm. We need to put more devices into consumers' hands. And this product has become a productivity tool, mm-hmm. right? You can be able to access your email, you can be able to do your conference calls on your device. You spend most likely 9 out of your 24 hours on the device, because mm-hmm. every time you pick, they say the consumer looks at their device around 4 times every minute. Yeah. So it's an extension of your lifestyle. It's an extension of your life. Mm-hmm. So you need to make it as cheap as possible to you to mm-hmm. be able to access that. Mm-hmm. And if you look at the access on of internet, 99% of the access of internet goes through the mobile device. So it tells you a story that the device is key is king. So I think if we can look at that, it will be fantastic. Also, we need to tighten the regulation on counterfeit. We also need to do more in terms of storming the market to ensure that we root out all these guys.
Many thanks there.
Thank you so much.
Speaking to Livingstone Migwi, the general manager of Tecno, of course indicating that they would like to see stepped up surveillance as well as a relook at the VAT bill.